More than half the U.S. population has gotten at least one dose of the COVID vaccine. And with more people getting the shots, more people are boarding planes these days, about 2 million people a day, according to TSA estimates. But before it's wheels up, let's talk about one claim spreading online, which has been taking off. Posts like these claim that airline companies met to discuss and consider banning people who are vaccinated from flying because of the risk of blood clots. So let's verify, is this true? Our source is the International Air Transport Association, or the IATA. One of their spokespeople told our researchers that they're not aware of any meeting like this and said that they believe that vaccinated people who want to travel should be, quote, free to travel without restriction. They also explained that the type of rare blood clot associated with some COVID vaccines is not the same type of clot that's linked to long periods of sitting, like during a flight. We then turned to the CDC for more information. According to their website, the clots that can happen during long distance flights are called deep vein thrombosis, which can occur in the legs. Meanwhile, the blood clots found in 6 people who received the Johnson & Johnson vaccine was called cerebral venous sinus thrombosis, which happens in the brain, abdomen, or legs. Dr. William Schaffner, an infectious disease specialist at Vanderbilt University, told our researchers he hasn't seen any data suggesting that vaccinated people are at a greater risk of blood clotting in flight. In fact, the CDC specifically says that you should, quote, delay travel until you are fully vaccinated. Regarding this claim about a secret meeting to ban vaccinated passengers, a spokesperson for Southwest, one of the largest domestic airlines, told our researchers succinctly, this is not accurate. So we can verify that no, posts like these are false. With your Verify, I'm Evan Kozloff, 13 News.